there, Joan?
2 years?
2 years ago? Yeah. About.
Christ, a lot's happened since then, isn't it? Broke up with the Eastern Bloc.
Change your hands.
Oh, yeah, yeah. Well, why I changed actors is because I come in one day with my cap on and my glasses. I threw my kids in there and I walked in and they all said at once, "It's only me." And I looked in the mirror and they was right. It's just what bloody look like. So I've got this out as a present. Jordan in
her? Yeah. Oh, yeah.
Yeah. Right, I'll start off with an old blues I used to do. You said it's back in the 50s when I used to be a Negro. Because I ain't got no honey, baby, now. I ain't got no honey, baby, now. I'll mix up another one in the middle of it by my hero, Tim Harding. And I used to do this song of his before I met him, and the lyric said, "I bought myself a red balloon, I got a blue surprise, hidden in the red balloon, dimming of my eyes." I used to sing that, didn't know what the bloody hell it meant. But I was lucky to do a concert with him before he died, obviously, and he told me what it meant. Well, what I meant, poor old Tim Harding, he's a lovely bloke, but he was a junkie, what killed him. And he came off it, he told me, for a couple of years, but he went back on it. And the bloke who used to sell it in America where he lived, he used to sell these coloured balloons as a cover. And if you bought the red one, it had the junkie, so that's cleared that up, isn't it? And his wife found out and left him, and it broke his heart, and he never really got over it. And he died about a month after I met him, actually. Ain't got no honey, baby, now. Ain't got no honey, baby, now. I was going to have to drive him home that night from Nottingham to London. And I thought, oh, brilliant. I had 3 hours with my hero, and we'll have a long chat with him, good friends. In fact, Charles had his girlfriend with him. A very pretty American girl with black teeth. It wasn't dirty, though. It was dyed black, for Christ's sake. It was some kind of beatnik affectation of the time. Yeah. Ain't Gordon that never caught on. You know that silly cow with the black teeth never shut up all the way home. Tim Harding fell asleep on the back seat. He only said one word all the way home. I see him in the mirror, I see him rise up like Dracula out of the back seat. Just as we was passing the sign for Loughborough, and everywhere he looked at him, he went, Locked down when it's asleep. Bloody silly all the way. I'll pop myself a red balloon. I've got a blue surprise. Hidden in the red balloon. The dimming of my eyes. It took a love light from my eyes. Blue surprise. We met as friends and it was so easy to get to know. Will we ever see one another again? Oh my, I hope so. I played with toys for children as a child I got. I haven't any time for children, though I've got a lot. She took a love light from my eyes, no surprise. We met as friends and you were so easy to get to know. Will we ever see one another again? Oh my, I hope so. So I bought myself a red balloon. I got a blue surprise. Hidden in the red balloon. The dimming of my eyes. She took a love light from my eyes. Blue surprise. Come when your troubles get like mine. Come when your troubles get like mine. Oh me, oh Lord in mine. I said come when your troubles get like mine. Last time. Ain't got no honey baby now. Ain't got no honey baby. Song now, it's a lullaby, and I used to sing this song to my children when they was little, and I hated it. Now I sing it to my grandchildren, and they hate it. So you have to sing the grown ups. Take you to a magic shining sea. Maybe we can catch a thousand silver fish. If you play with them, you'll grant your every wish. And if you want your friends to come, bring them all along. And if you want to get a star, then come my way. I will take you when my time's always day. You can follow me, and if you really do try, maybe we can catch a rainbow to teach it to fly. And if you want your friends to come, bring them all along. I will take you to the magic dancing wood. I will take you where the goblins all are good. I will take you to the magic fairy ring. I will take you where the owls and pixies sing. And if you want your friends to come, bring them all along. So bow your head and let your eyelids close on down. If you are going, there's no need to bring your frown. And you will find that all the things that I have said will come true when you are sleeping in your bed. And if you want your friends to come, bring them on. I got lost when I got in the bloody pub. What a loser. I'm getting very forgetful now, I'm getting old. I never thought I'd start forgetting things and mixing words up. Let me know, mate. What's happening, Jane? Yeah, I play golf a couple of times a week, and there's about 12 of us. And we've been playing for 20 years, and we're all about the same age, mid-40s. hell of a lot more. Anyway, I heard Lionel talking to Billy at the bar a couple of weeks ago. And Billy said, I don't know what's the matter with me, I think I've got that euthymal disease. He says, how do you mean? He says, I keep mixing things up and forget. He says, how do you mean? He says, well, I'm taking my wife to America for Christmas. I went to get the tickets, I meant to say to the girl at the counter, like, can I have two tickets to Pittsburgh? And I messed it up. I said, can I have two tickets to Pittsburgh? And they slammed me out. And Lionel says, I'll do that. I know what you mean, Billy. You go to say something and something else comes out inadvertently. Don't, I'll do it all the way, don't worry. See, I did it this morning, having breakfast with my wife. I meant to say to her was, are there any cornflakes left? What I did say was, you rotten cow, you've ruined my life. Honestly, but there's this one while I'm in this tuning. It's an old man song, really, an old traveller man song. It's about an old man travelling. Got new strings on here. And it ain't exactly a chorus, but there's bits you can join in that have become sort of quite apparent where they are. Won't you come and gather round me? Listen to my tale of woe. Some good advice to give you, something that you ought to know. Take a tip from one who's traveled, I'll never stop rambling around. Once you get the wrong feeling, you're never gonna settle down. No, you're never gonna settle down. I met a little girl in Frisco, I asked her to be my wife. Told her I was tired of rolling, I want to settle down for life. But then I hear the whistle blowing, I think it was a dead ball train. I left the stand by the railroad and I never saw the gal again. Oh, I never saw the gal again. It's your bit. Saw the gal again. I never saw the gal again.
country. I've been almost everywhere. I've been in the mainline railroad and I've never paid a nickel fare. I've been from Maine to California, Canada to Mexico. It saved no money, and now I got no place to go. Now I got no place to go. I've got no place to go. Now I got no place to go. 'Cause I never did save no money. Now I got no place to go. So listen to old Boomer's story. Pay attention to what I say. I hear another train coming. It got me on my way. I really wanna do me a favor. When I lay me down to die, stick my grave beside the railroad so I can hear the train go by. I can hear the train go by.
Down the front. I finished the first song and she yells out, "Sing Barbara Allen." So I done it, I did another song, finished that, "Sing Barbara Allen." Bloody night, she's on about Barbara Allen. Suddenly I thought, hang on, I do know that. Yeah, anybody of my own age group from London, there was two songs that was built into our little heads when we was little kids. And Barbara Allen was half of them. The other half was, "And did those feet in ancient times walk up on England's mountains?" Look out! It was that Blitz song. "And in Scarlet Town, where I was born, there was a fair maid dwelling, made every youth cry like a den, and it was Barbara Allen." Oh, I must know that. So I said, "Oh, I've got enough." And I did, and I'd heard a version of it in 4/4 times somewhere, and I just did it. And it's all right, I only missed out about 7 verses. But the thing is, I didn't realise what a terrific story it was. You know, you hear these songs from childhood millions of times, but you never really listen to the words, do you? "He sent his servant to the town."
Yeah.
"Oh, mother, mother, make my bed."
Yeah.
You don't really listen to them, do you? Of course, when you sing it, you have to, or you cock it up. So the first time I ever really heard it was that night I sung it. And I thought it was brilliant. I didn't want to finish. It's about this Scots girl, Barbara Allen, obviously, a couple of hundred years ago, falls in love with a local rich fella called Sweet William. It's a bit sus, isn't it? And they have a get it together. They have a scene, and then they fell out. Now, I'm not quite sure why. According to the song, it slighted her. I'm not really sure what that means, but it doesn't sound very nice, really.
Any chance of a slight, darling?
Anyway, we give up another slight. And it fell out, see, so. Sometime later, William was laying on his bed with all his mates around him, and he's dying. And he's laying there, all wham. That's another word we don't use these days, isn't it? "Oh, don't he look wham?" He does look wham. But anyway, he remembered that he still loved her, so he sent one of his mates to get her. "He sent his servant to the town, to the place where she was dwelling," says the song. But of course, she's still got the hump with William for being slighted. But she went and see him anyway, apparently. And apparently she just walked into the room and he's lying there all sort of waiting. And she just looked at him and went, he buggered her phone. and he died, poor soul. She was full of remorse, so she got her mother to dig her grave. A mother, mother, make my bed, make it deep, make it narrow. Means dig a grave. For Christ's sake, what a thing to ask your mum to do. Dig a grave, mum. I don't think it ever happened, really. So her mum dug her grave, and then Barbara topped herself, and that's the story. Barrel of laughs, isn't it? Seriously, it is a beautiful song, and you can join in if you like. I'll finish every verse with, and it was Barbara, like that. I swear I've got this guitar miles too low, I don't know what I've done. Scarlet Town, where I was born. There was a fair maid where made every bright like a day. Her name was Barbara. It was all in the month of May, when the green buds lay was blooming. Sweet wedding on his deathbed day, for the love of Barbara. So he sent his servant to the town, to the place where she was dwelling. My master's sick, and he sends for you, if your name is Barbara. So slowly, slowly she got up, and slowly, slowly she came nigh, and the only words to him did say, young man, I think you're dying. So he turned his face round to the wall, and death was on him laying. He said farewell, not come resolve. He declined to Barbara. Yeah. Oh, she walked a long way home. She heard the death bells telling, and every stroke it seemed to say, our cottage Barbara. Her younger sister, she said to her, oh, Bonnie Bobby, take it, there's time enough to tell me now, when his death clothes they are so. You remember once in yonder town, when they were standing round the tavern, and he drank the health of his comrades all, but he slighted Barbara. Oh, mother, mother, make my bed,
and buried her in the old churchyard. Sweet William was buried now, and on his grave grew a red, red rose. And the Barbara, the briar. They grew and they grew in the old churchyard, till they could grow no higher, entwined into a lover's knot. All true love to a knight. If anyone knows it, in Scarlet Town, where I was born, there was a fair maiden, made every crack and nag a bed. Her name was
long song I'll do, I promise you. I'm going to do a short song now. This song should be sung by a lady. So you've got to imagine I'm a lady. This girl has just given her bloke the order of the Spanish archer, the elbow. I don't know exactly what he's done, but she's given the old Evo and she's singing this song. Apropos of this song, there was an actor in America just after the war, and he was a brilliant actor. But he could never get any work. And he rang up his agent, he says, "Look, I'm a good actor. Why don't you give me any work?" He says, you're the best actor on my books. But I'll tell you, mate, no one's going to employ you with that rotten blooming name of yours. He said, "What's the matter with my name?" He says, "Penis of the Lesbian." What sort of name is that? He says, "I can't help it. My parents were Belarusian." He says, "But for God's sake, who wants to see Penis of the Lesbian up outside the theatre in lights, for Christ's sake, and on a probe?" He said, "I'll tell you, Peen, you've got all grit." He says, "I'll never get you any work." He sees him a couple of weeks later, he says, "You ordered your name yet?" He says, "Yeah. Yeah, I translated it." He said, "What do you call yourself now?" He said, "Dick Van Dyke." please don't think I've been politically incorrect here. I don't mean any offence to... I don't mean any offence to ladies with short hair and sensible shoes. They said our love would never last. They said that when I met you. Blimey, who was that? A bit of left lung just whistled past my ear. I'll go up one. Maybe jump in. I'll find it, take it out and have it analysed. They said our love would never last. They said that when I met you. They was right and I was wrong, and now I can't forget you. When I hear the neighbours yelling, when all day I keep on smelling old men's smacks, when both my ears are blocked with wax, when conversation turns to tack, sit down the other thing of you. And when I see a child dismember insects, and when I remember how I feel the day after an Indian leaf, whenever I see jelly leaves, my darling, I will think of you. And when they ask me why I like you, well, what could they become me? when I think of Dick Van Dyke,
singing in a Cockney accent.
And when the shop is out of Pfizer, and when above my head there flies a jumbo jet, when all my towels are really wet, and when my pink lemons work set, I don't know a thing of you. And when my aunt says time for shut eye, when I wash the dishes but I get no thanks, whenever I smell septic tanks, whenever I see two short planks, my darling old thing of you. I know Joan Light's coming from Africa, but a good old friend of mine died last year, and his name was Jean Bosco Mwenda. Now, Jean came from Zaire. Well, he didn't actually, because he never left there. But if he had done, he would. How can you come from somewhere if you've never bloody left there? That's another thing, you start questioning cliches when you get older, or as I say, in Paris, fidgets. For instance, on the way here tonight, I saw a police car on their own, and I thought, shit. I thought, I'm turning into a police car. It just goes straight with consciousness. Anyway, Jean was a nice old boy, and I'm going to sing this song in Jean's language. And he had a nephew and niece called Nana and Wendy, who were his only relatives. And all he's singing is, they're a brother and sister. He's saying, Nana and Wendy are on their way to Jadaville to see their Uncle Bosco. That's all it means. And in young Wendy, did he to Jadaville. And in young one, yeah, Baba Bosco, what are you? Everyone. He had a lovely picking style up, Jean, which I'll try to get older. It's nice and quiet in here, isn't it? You know this. Quiet audiences are all right as long as they ain't moving towards you.
Thank you.
Couple more. Okay, Debbie. No,
I've got my glasses on.
You and Joe look very alike.
Yes.
Two red
spurs.
It's a nose ring. Can I sing a song from the 60s?
Yeah.
There used to be a bloke, used to get a lot of American folk singers come over in the 60s, millions of them, get off the plane at Heathrow with a big Martin guitars. I'm gonna be a star. There's a bunch of, well, a lot of them weren't very good. some of them was all right. Bob Dylan, Paul Simmons. But the best of all, I reckon, was a smashing bloke called Jackson C. Frank. Some of you might have heard of him. Old Jack was a genius, and he only made one album, unfortunately. I'm talking about him in the past tense. He might be still alive for all I know, but old Jack did drink, you know, and the last I heard of him, he was a bum and on Skid Row in New York. Didn't even own a guitar. It's a great tragedy. And he was a big, sort of, huge bloke with loads of hair and all scars all down his face. Jack thought he was ugly. Well, he was. But he was beautiful as well, old Jack. He had a gorgeous voice. He wrote Blues Run the Game. Do you remember that song? Yeah. To go to England, baby, the beach in Spain. Wherever I've gone, wherever I've been and gone, wherever I've gone, blues run the game. Have you ever heard that song? Yeah. Best song to come out. Well, Jack wrote that. And here's another one of his songs. I always think of old Jack, Les Cousins at 3 o'clock in the morning. Les Cousins was a club in Greek Street.
Yep.
All the rich people used to call it Le Cousin. Oh, it wasn't, it was Les Cousins. I always think of old Jack there, 3 o'clock in the morning, sitting up there with his twisted old face. Sing this song. It had a very, very bad love affair. This might interest you, right? I'm sorry to talk so much, but I haven't seen anybody all day. How old Jack got them scars is quite interesting. When he was a kid, he lived in Buffalo, New Jersey, where this years after he disappeared from Theo Johnson's house. And he's in a school that had a potbelly stove in this little village, and it blew up. And the bloody school burned down. There's all kids killed and everything, and a load of them hurt very badly. It was like, you know, American version of Aberfan sort of thing. It's a very famous sort of, or infamous occurrence. And Jack was one of the kids who got badly burned. That was some of the scars. And when he was 18, he got $1 million. He was a millionaire when we knew him. I used to give people guitars and things.
Have a guitar.
He reckoned he didn't earn it, so he didn't really want it. Never bloody give me a guitar. And he got rid of it all, one way or another. Lovely boy though.
Wandering and wailing, my back against the wall. Not a word that passed between us ever comes to call. Just a shadow on the window as you walk on down the hall. You never wanted me, babe. You never knew me at all. I haven't any picture to set before my eyes. There's nothing to blame when the blues start to rise. There's just the memory of our love and the living of our lives. What would change my ways, babe, if I never said goodbye? And if you ever get the time, baby, please think of me. It's a lock that can't be broken, there isn't any key. Cause if I'm only in your mind, don't think you can set me free. But you can't hurt me anymore, babe, and that isn't hard to see. Someday someone will leave you, and I know you'll feel the same. But you'll mark it down to memory, and a dream that never came. Cause there are no answers given when love is just a game. You never wanted me, babe, and now I feel the same.
And she was a real American traditional folk singer. And she taught me loads of stuff, and I learned a lot of stuff from her and Daryl Adams. And all the old songs I know are all American, not English. It's peculiar. I'm not a traditional singer, obviously. You can't be, can you, come to the East End? Hey. How can I sing about bloody mining and fishing and fox hunting? Bullshit, wouldn't it? Although my dad was down in the labour exchange as a shepherd for 30 years. the British traditional singers, a lot of their songs are surprisingly young. They just sound old. Ewan McColl wrote most of them. But it's surprising how sort of quite recent some of them are. But all the songs I know from America are all the last century. This one's from the 1860s. And I've learned it off a heady. It's a very famous song. And I love it because it's so American. It couldn't come from anywhere else but Missouri in the 1860s. It's a ballad of Willie Moore. And I did know it actually before then, but she taught me it properly. Talking about the Old West, I was lying in bed the other morning, I was thinking about old Roy Rogers. Do you remember him? He just popped into my head. And he's riding along on the trigger, and he's singing, "Oh, give me a home where the buffalo roam, where the deer and the antelope play." And he sees these two deers standing by the wood. So he gets off his horse, he walks over to him, puts his hands on his hips, and he says to him, "You're bloody useless, you two. You're rubbish. You're the worst two deers in all of America. A pair of you. You're a waste of bloody space." Got his horse and buggered off. And one deer turns to the other one and he says, "Oh, whatever happened to seldom is heard a discouraging word?" Sorry. 2 years since I've been here, bloody hell. Yeah, there's two momentous occurrences have happened. The breakup of the Eastern Bloc, and my cat died. You know, not bloody funny, we're laughing at this. Let me tell you about it. For my silver wedding, I love cats, and Lady Brimstone hates them. So I've got one for her 25th anniversary. It cost me a fortune. And he was a chinchilla, and he cost a bloody fortune even then. And he had a Russian name about that long. And if he could have spoken, he wouldn't have talked to us, I tell you. And he was... Anyway. Me and Colin Scott had come over from Amsterdam, and there's hundreds of people come over for that day, you know. And I paid for him a week before, and we went and got him in, smuggled him in a box, plonked him in the middle of the... You ever seen a chinchilla kitten? Instant love. And she's walking in, there's Charlie looking up. And, well, you know, she worships old Charlie. Anyway, he grew up to be a sort of sheep. He was vast, he was the biggest bloody cat you've ever seen. You know? Great big thick legs. He always looked like he had the hump. And all the kids love him because he looked like a teddy bear. Anyway, he got sort of old, really old. And last year, poor old Charlie, he got Catzheimer disease. He sat in some doggy doos, which ain't something a cat usually does, is it? Anyway, he's come walking in. And I says, "Oh, Christ, what's he saying?" And Jean says, "Oh, no. He's saying some dog shit, Derek." I says, "Oh, no." And he looks at us and goes... So I said, "We better clean him up." So anyway, it took two of us to lift him up in the draining pool. He's so vast. There's Jean, he got his tail up in the air, and an old plastic bowl we had full of suds, and an old J-Cloth, he's going, splat, splat. And he's really pissed off. He's got his bum up in the air, going, wow. So I walked out the front door in the edge trimmer. I'm halfway up the path, and it was like something out of a Fellini film. Four pairs of American Seventh-day Adventists are walking past. You get me, the blokes in sort of suits and crew cuts and briefcases spreading the word. And their wives are all smart with headscarves tied under here like the Queen of the Corgis. And they're going around spreading the word to us evens. Anyway, there's these... I got squad walking past. I'm halfway out the path of the gym. Jeannie lobs Charlie out the front door like a sort of Polaris missile. He's hit the ground and gone straight under an edge, and she's yelled up the path, "Don't you come back in here till your bum's dry." Hell of me. There's some eyes left. I'm going, is it? I wonder if they discussed it that night at the Bible meeting.
This may have some significance, sir. Go don't you come back in here to drive.
Right, put him over.
There's something wrong here, I've got a fret sprung. So tight.
Died from the brawl.